Well, this morning's coffee with a lot of fun.
It's with Tom Myers.
Yeah.
Tom, welcome to WJZ. Good morning. How are
pleasure.
You?
Pleasure having you. Pleasure to be on. Thanks for having me.
Glad you're
what
with
I want
us.
Everybody to do is
great reaction.
Google
thank you. Thank
the
you
crowd
so much.
Loves you.
I was wondering how you got them to be so cheerful this early in the morning, and now I see it. Knife point. That's very.
Hey, wait a minute. Why are you moving them all into the storage area? Wait, where are they going?
So now we're down to 3 minutes and 30 seconds. What I want everybody to do is Google Tom Myers, 2ms.us. And you'll be able to get an interesting view of a local guy trying to make it big, staying here. Or just Google Tom Myers. You live up in Harford County. You got a great body of work in comedy, but you're trying to still stay here.
Well, good. We're glad you are.
Well, I mean, I'm trying to keep as much of it like in Maryland as possible, just because, you know, I travel enough. For comedy, and just I hate the idea of just packing up a suitcase and going on the road, because I'm sort of envious of like prop comics, especially people have to remember to take all these items with them, and then I get to a place and then I stress because I'm like, I forgot socks.
Gotcha.
Now I have to go out and buy socks.
So just like some of the smooth jazz guys that we talk about that live here, I'll just pick one out: Ken Navarro or Mesa. How tough is it for you as a comedian, because they can do their studio here, they can ship their music out, but dude, you gotta be on stage.
Are there enough clubs?
Yeah.
I mean, there's enough spaces to perform in Maryland and DC, but I mean, any comic will tell you, you have to go on the road. Like, you know, like Jeff Foxworthy, you can't stay in Georgia and try and make it. You have to go on the road.
So it's a fact of life, no matter where you live.
Right. I mean, I could stay in Maryland, or I could move to New York, or I could move to Los Angeles. But you know, the fact of the matter is, if you want to make any money, you have to.
So if you're in LA, you're gonna fly to Havre Grace.
Exactly. Well, that's speaking of Havre Grace, that's where I recorded.
Oh, getting ready to get to that
boy. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So tell me, do you keep your comedy local? In other words, if you know you're performing a lot local, do you play around with local politics, local accents, local landmarks, stuff like that?
I may keep it local for a little bit, but for when I'm recording something, obviously I want to go ahead and appeal to a wider audience. So, I mean, I talk a little bit about me on here. I discuss current events. I do politics. I talk about, you know, some things that amuse me, and hopefully everyone else.
We just learned how dangerous talking politics can be for a comedian this weekend, didn't we?
Well, I mean, the way I see it is, you know, I don't think there are any lines. It's like the idea of being shocked when you hire a comedian to make jokes, and then you get upset at the fact that, you know, they're doing their job is that sort of.
What did George Carlin say? Nothing sacred from satire?
George Carlin's most famous thing, I can't say on this network.
No, you
being
can.
Bleeped,
can't
so.
Say it.
Although he'd like you to.
Make America Innate Again. You recorded that. You know, it's interesting. Doing something live, when you know it's being recorded, the pressure factor amps up. Did you have the option of doing 4 or 5 shows and taking the best? Or was it like one take, do it?
Well, it was one take, do it. And I'll tell you what, the nice thing about recordings is people, when they know they're being recorded, they kind of want to hear themselves. They want to hear themselves laughing on the CD.
Well,
so
told
actually, the original title of this was supposed to be Sit Down and Shut Up, You Morons.
That was going to be the title of your CD?
People thought that was a bit much. Yeah. Telling someone to sit down.
No, I got to be honest with you. That kind of brought me in the house. No.
Telling someone to sit down is a bit strong.
If you're trying to get people to purchase it, yes. If you just want them to look at it and think it's a funny title, but
Okay. Oops. It does fly out of your hands. Well, nice and smooth. Good quality cardboard.
Oh yeah.
Where can someone get this?
It's on my website, tommyers.us.
T-O-M-Y, two B's. T-O-M-Y-E-R-S.
But before we buy it, we may want to hear you be funny. So where can we hear you be funny?
I have various videos on YouTube.
And there you go.
CD is also available on iTunes, Spotify, all those streaming services.
Out of sight.
As well, so.
Hey, congratulations, man. Keep your dream coming true.
I appreciate it. Hey, listen, pleasure being on here with both of you guys.
We need comics these days. We need all the laughs we can get where
I'm here, and I'm somewhat bookable.
I admire this, everybody.
All right, Tom. Thank you. Stay with WJZ.